I'm Robert Osborne. Every Monday in primetime since September 2nd here on TCM, we premiered a new chapter in the documentary series, The Story of Film and Odyssey, a series which focuses not just on movies of Hollywood, but filmmaking all around the world. And tonight the subject is what was happening on the international film front in the 1950s. Back to discuss this next chapter is the man who created, wrote, directed, and narrates the documentary series, film historian Mark Cousins. And first, I have to, for those who haven't been with us from the very beginning, have to kind of restate your credentials in doing this. You are a filmmaker from?
Filmmaker from Ireland, living in Scotland. I fell in love with movies as a child. Then I studied film history and art history and started making documentaries. Mm-hmm. But I felt that I had a head full of cinema, and I wrote some books. I think I've done 5 books on movie history, etc.
Including one called A Story of Film.
Yeah. And I wanted, in that book, I wanted to write not about showbiz, not about box office, not even about Oscars, just about innovation in cinema. Who were the innovators? And that's what I did.
And you and another fellow went out on your own and kind of got the financing to do this and traveled all over the world
doing interviews. In West Africa and Iran and China and Scandinavia, all over North America, just sort of globetrotting. And it was sort of like making a road movie about the history of cinema. And we visited the famous studios where many films were made, the grave sites of some of the great filmmakers. I remember going to Buster Keaton's grave and laying flowers on his grave and walking from Billy Wilder's grave to William Wyler's grave, etc. So it was a labor of love.
Yeah. So let's talk about this next chapter, what we're about to see.
Yes. We're going to the 1950s. Mm-hmm. This was a time of great social change, as you know. Teenagers. Africa was decolonizing. Rock and roll was coming along. And cinema, you could say, had maybe been slightly behind the times. You know, it was wonderful, but we were slightly in the era of a kind of Doris Day, a sort of slightly optimistic.
Well, because Hollywood is still dominating all this at this point, right?
Yes.
But the world is now becoming really a part of all of
this
sort of stuff.
And if you look at world cinema in the 1950s, you notice there was one style that dominated. It was like the melodrama. The melodrama, as you know, is like a pressure cooker, which is full of pent-up emotions. And that really reflected the pent-up emotions around the world. So if you go to Egypt, you find the melodrama. If you go to India, you find the melodrama. Japan. And of course, if you come here to America, you get James Dean. You get those actor studio pictures coming out of New York City, etc. So all around the world, there was this cinema bursting at the seams.
And here you also have television entering the scene, competing with films.
Yeah.
So that's throwing a whole thing into the picture.
Yeah, the audiences are being drawn to TV. Television is live, so it's got that nervy energy. As you know, Marty, the original TV program, was live. Rod Steiger walked out on the streets of New York the next day, and people were recognizing him from TV last night. That kind of vitality, that kind of spark, Hollywood had lost a little bit. It had to get its mojo back, and of course it did, as we discover it does, but Hollywood was not going to lose the audience. It had to hold on to the audience, so it had to modernize.
Yeah, and you have that thing about the House Un-American Activities Committee coming up, and you also got the, again, that terrific competition from television, and you've got
there's so much going on,
widescreen, everything like that.
A time of real flux.
Yeah, chaos, actually. Yeah, no one knew where it was going.
Yeah. And nobody knew less than Hollywood at this moment. Sometimes Hollywood led the way in the 20s, and in other times, not at this point. Yeah. It was behind the curve.
Yeah, such an interesting time. Let's have a look. Here making its U.S. television debut, Chapter 6 of The Story of Film and Odyssey, subtitled The Swollen Story, World Cinema Bursting at the Seams.